Last thing we're going to take a look at is pie charts, properly labeling them and putting everything in the right order. So, with a pie chart, sometimes called a circle graph, what we're going to do is start with our big open circle. And whenever we're dealing with a pie chart, we're always looking at percentages because we want to know what percent of the circle each part will get, how big of a slice everything will get. And we always are going to start with the largest one. Again, like we mentioned earlier, we started with ordering our frequency table from greatest to least, and that way this will be very easy for us. So that's, again, just a reminder to do that. We're going to look at the relative frequency. So the relative frequency of our largest slice is 50%, and that's for the green. So 50% of a circle is pretty easy. That's going to be about half. So we're going to draw about half of this here as our green section. So we'll go ahead and just copy that label right in. And now there's a couple different ways of doing this. You can put the frequency in, 25, or some people choose to use the relative frequency. Depends what your situation requires. So we'll go ahead and use the relative frequency in this one. Next one, our next biggest thing is gold. That is 30%. So 30% is going to be a little bit bigger than a quarter. So we'll draw that in roughly around here. And let's go ahead and then drag in our label and our percentage. And then finally, our last two, it's going to be the red and purple, each with 10%. So we'll break this in half. And sometimes your labels will not fit in the circle. So when that happens, you can let them hang out outside just a little bit. So something like what I'm doing here. And now you have all the major parts of your pie graph. So the last thing that we need to do is, of course, always add a title. So favorite color choices. And if you want to be a little more descriptive, maybe it's of local high school students. And then you can put that title right up on top, and here you go, you have yourself a pie graph. Thinking about what we did with the pie graph versus the bar graph, reasons why you might want to use one or the other. If you notice here on the pie graph, the emphasis is on the percentage. You can see that green takes up a big chunk of this, whereas the other ones are a little bit smaller. On the bar graph, you get a much better idea of how many of each category there are. Whereas with the pie chart, the percentage again is emphasized. So, although it is possible to do the relative frequency on a bar graph, if that's your emphasis, that's what you really want to show, pie graph is probably going to be your best option.